Shalom. Giving all praise to the Most High Yahweh, by Hashem, Yahshua, by Hashem, Makar Kadosh. Double honor to the apostles and the elders of great millstone, to the teachers and the acting of their prophets, who are in truth and sincerity. It's probably around me, and I'm just preparing myself to head on out. But thought came to me, so I'm just going to put it to audio, you know, video. And you know, unless the videos are actual live images or recording of yourself or got a lot of pictures, you know, that's when Jake tends to watch more and you get more views because it's exciting to the eyes. But when it's simple audio videos and so-called boring breakdowns and nothing entertainment-wise, that's when you get lower views. Because most of you people out there see this thing as entertainment. But anyways, you know, still gonna put it out, and whoever listens, listens, man. You know. But I was reading over some of the law, cause 2018, we're living in a time of prophecy. But it was also, and I was also thinking earlier this morning, along with going into the prophecies, you gotta go into the basics, man. Because a lot of the elect wouldn't, a lot of the elect that's gonna be woken up at the last trump, the last sounding, the last cry, the last call from the men on the highways and the byways, a lot of the elect wouldn't have been in this thing for the years that the other Akim have. A lot of the elect won't even have been in the truth for a year, you know. Some of them just don't wake up at the last minute and the Lord gonna put that spirit on them, you know. So here we are talking about prophecy, but we gotta, what did the scripture say? Consume the whole roll. So whilst we talk about prophecy, we gotta go into the basics of who the Lord is, man. Because there ain't no point. Well, you can't understand prophecy if you don't know who the Lord is, but there ain't no point teaching prophecy and having dummies and machines repeating after you, no, this is that, that is that, and they don't know the basics of who you have about Hashem, Yahshua, about Hashem, Makar Kadosh is, man. You know, it would be pointless. So, as the scriptures say, a false balance is an abomination unto Yahweh, you know, by power. So, as much as we push these prophecies, you've got to push them basics, them milk scriptures, them intermediate must scriptures, and the heavy meat scriptures, man. Now, and the scriptures don't say intermediate must. I'm just adding that for, you know, a joke. But really and truly, the seriousness of the point is you've got to push both the milk and the meat, man. Okay? Because to be a man of the Lord, you don't want to stand before the Lord and he rejects you even though you taught this word, man, because you didn't teach it right. But anyways, you know me, always thinking outside of the box. I was thinking, man, that over the years, pigeons. I think these are pigeons. Yes, pigeons. The little birds, pigeons. They're becoming more brave, man. You know, back in the day, you would walk past a pigeon, and before you get a few steps near it, the thing's already scared of you flying off. You know, when you're driving on the roads. Sometimes, you know, when I was back in London, when I had access to a car, and I would drive. They would fly out the way. Now they're moving at the last second. They're walking right in front of your path, like literally right in front of your foot. You know, they ain't scared of you no more. And when you go into the scriptures and the etymology of words, we are a god over those things, those animals. We are a god over this earth, man. We are gods over this earth. Now we ain't living it out right now, but in our natural state, we are gods over the earth itself and the animals and all that there is in. And if you say, well, where's your evidence for that? Go and look at Genesis 1, where the Most High said to Adam, which is Yahweh Shai, the same spirit of Yahweh Shai, he said to Adam, okay, pretty much, you go have dominion and power over these, the earth itself, to till it, and all the animals, which really went into the actual physical earth and all that's in it, so the animals and even all the other nations, man. You know, so he was a god, you know, and the word became flesh, man. In the beginning was the word, that's that spirit of Yahweh Shai, the first begotten, and that word became flesh. Yahweh sent that word into the flesh, into the earth, first as Adam, then as Yahweh Shai, but in between that he came as other people, Solomon, Isaac, and this goes on, Melchizedek. But anyway, not to get away from the point, I was reading through, like I said, the law, and I got to Leviticus 15, talking about sexual impurity, you know, what to do after you deal with a woman, or what women should do when they're on their periods, etc. Just going, I know this thing, but I'm just going through it, you know. And a few other different chapters that dealt with some other things in the law of Leviticus. Hey, because we are the priests, man. The priesthood is open to all Israel, not only just the Levites, all Israelites, all tribes. And basically, one of the sacrifices for uncleanness is a turtle dove or a young pigeon. Now, why did the Lord choose pigeons, man? Because they're easily accessible, man. They're always around, okay? Even in this day and age, pigeons, man, wherever you go, America, UK, Canada, Germany, wherever you go, man, pigeons are always around, man. Now, albeit they used to be more scared of their powers, or humans, men, if you want to put it that way, you know, I understand this, eh? Now they're just bold, man, but they dying more, you know? They're getting hit by cars more, they're getting kicked by little children more, they're getting greedy, you know? When there's food in the road, they try and get it, and then they get run over by a car, because they're being more brave, man, okay? Now the scripture says that you can offer them as a sacrifice to atone for uncleanness, man, and a number of other things. But why the point is, why did the Lord use them, man? Because they're easily accessible, man. Okay? They're easy to get hold of. And, for example, the example I'm using today in Leviticus 15, the law of uncleanness, man. Now, to be unclean ain't a sin, it's just a state of being. Because you got them people that say, in Revelation, blessed are those who are not defiled by sexual by virgins, or I have to do a lesson on that anyway. So people believe that in the last days you can't deal with a woman because you're gonna be unclean. Nah, man. He's talking about the impurities of these other doctrines, man. But we're gonna go into that lesson, that's a deep topic anyway. Yeah? But the point is that Israel like to procreate, Israel like to, you know, I'm trying not to make this vulgar, but Israel likes to do their thing. Israelite men like to do their thing with their women, and equally the women like to do their thing with their men. Alright, so we would have been in a state of uncleanness quite often, man, you know what I mean. Hey, in the kingdom, we gonna be in a state of uncleanness for a long time, man. So we're going to have to bring back Israel. All these millions of Israelites, the elect, going to have to bring them back, man. And the law still stands in the kingdom. We're going to keep it perfectly. So So when the law says you shall be unclean until evening because of the seed of your copulation, both man and woman, then we gonna be unclean until evening, man. And we gonna wash and we gonna bathe in water, as the scripture says. Then we gonna present ourselves before Yahweh, you know, and be made clean, man. So ain't no problem being unclean, right? That's not a sin, it's just a state of being, right? Okay, but the point is that when they went to offer the turtle doves or the pigeons, they were easily accessible, man. Now, in the spirit, I was thinking to myself, why the hell are these pigeons so brave these days, man? Because they got a spirit on them too, you know? And with their braveness, like I said earlier, they're getting killed more, man. Alright? They're getting killed more. And it occurred to me that these pigeons, man, they represent the two-thirds of Israel, man. You know? Because, they being bold. They, what are these pigeons offered up? They're offered up for an unclean sacrifice, man. Oh, they're clean sacrifice, but they're offered up for uncleanness, man. And that's what two-thirds of Israel are. They're unclean, man. In their philosophies, whether be it Islam, be it Kemet, be it Christianity, be it Buddhism, be it atheism, whatever it is, man, they're unclean in their philosophies, they're unclean in their foods, they're unclean in their practices, man. You know? It's not according to the scriptures. Salakia. And the same way pigeons are bold in their mannerism and it gets them put to death, it gets them killed, it's the same way these Israelites are being bold in their uncleanness, man. They're becoming more bold and bold. Like back in the day, if you were gay or homosexual, I use the correct term because gay means happy, man, with the connotation of the word change. But back in the day, if you were a homosexual, you know, you would keep that on the down low. Now, they're telling you, you wrong for being heterosexual, and what's wrong with being homosexual, you know? They're being bold with it. That's just one example, you know? And just like the pigeons being more bold gets them killed, it's the same thing with the two-thirds, man. And what was a pigeon? A sacrifice, man. Now, what's two-thirds of Israel going to be? They're going to be a sacrifice. It's a mercy killing, but they're going to be a sacrifice, man. Alright? Their blood is going to atone for the nonsense that they've been doing for the hundreds of years. Hundreds and hundreds of years. Through their reincarnation, man. You know? They're going to have to pay. They're going to be a sacrifice, man. Alright? As is the pigeon, so is the two-thirds of Israel, man. That's going to be the title of this lesson, man. You know? Now, I ain't got my scriptures on me, because like I said, I'm getting ready to head on out, but go and read Leviticus 15, you know. Where's that scripture, man? The scripture in the book of Zechariah, 2 shall be cut off and die. You know, go and revise those, you know. We the scripture to back everything we're saying, man. What I'm saying in this video. But as is the pigeon, so is the two-thirds of Israel, man. Y'all gonna get cut off and die, man. Because the Lord put that spirit on you to be bold, man. Like the pigeons are today. They walking in front of you, they ain't moving for cars no more, and they're getting killed. Same way you Israelites, you two-thirds be moving bold in your filth. That's why the scripture says in Revelation, go check this one out, man. He who is filthy, let him be filthy still. He who is unjust, let him be unjust still. He who is righteous, let him be righteous still. And that's what the Most High gonna say when the doors of salvation is cut, or closed, I should say, through the salvation of HaMashiach Yahusha. He's going to say, all right, cool. Those who be that have the spirit on them that are righteous, they righteous. Those who filthy, impure, and unjust, they like that. They stay like that. You know? Ain't no time to change. You know? So, I guess it's a time in this video calling you to repentance. Calling myself to repentance first, man. You know? Because I sin, man. I go off. You go off, man. And you gotta constantly pray to the Lord to forgive you and to put a spirit on you, creating me a clean heart and purify me, you know. As the psalmist David, that said, man, you know. But I think I got the point out, so I ain't gonna labour the point any further. But yeah, man, this is a lesson that you gotta have a spiritual eye to understand this one. Now, I ain't coming across deep. I ain't deep, man. I ain't trying to change the doctrine, you know. It's just a quick comparison and spoken thought that I've had. You know, I'm committing it to video so that maybe it may, you know, it may resonate with somebody. And if it doesn't, you know, if I'm wrong, then, you know, Yahabashim Yoshua, forgive me. You know. But it takes a spiritual eye to see this one, you know. But with that, I'll give all praises to the Most High, Yahweh, Vashem, Yahshai, Vashem, Makakadash, the bonus of the Apostle, knows of great millstone, man. Salutations to the sincere Akim, man. Barak Kau Akim, sincere of the Akim, sincere of the elect, you know, hopefully elect. As is the pigeon, so is the two-thirds of Israel. Oh.